This is Kumar exclusive. I repeat, America means first point, dollars. Okay? Second point, America means US flag. Second is green card. Third is US passport. And of course, snow, ice, right? And Texas, whatever the issues. I repeat, Telugu. అమెరికా అంటే డాలర్లు, గ్రీన్ కార్డు, యుఎస్ పాస్పోర్ట్ అండి. మెనీ పీపుల్ ఆస్క్ మీ కుమార్ హౌ మెనీ బిలియన్స్ డాలర్స్ మిలియన్ డాలర్స్ ఆర్ వాట్ యూ కాల్ ఇన్ ఇండియా క్రోర్స్ డిడ్ యూ బై ఎ హౌస్ ఇన్ ఇండియా సో లైక్ దట్ సో హియర్ ఈజ్ మై ప్రాపర్టీ మెమోరిస్టిక్స్ కెమెరాస్ and all the important documents to write a book. That's it. This is my property. I don't know those who earn houses, cars. I don't know how they get. My haters also started attacking when I placed this video in Telugu. Hi friends, in Telugu video, I told about my experiences with Ravi in 2014. In that interview, Indians in US unfit to go back. So he shared, when we discussed about social service, he said 85% he spends time to earn money for family. And then he may think of social services at the end of the life, maybe 5% or 10%. Is not benchmark for me, or I'm not comparing, but since that video is viral or popular, then Indians here lost self-confidence to go back to India. So I'm stressing that point. I don't know how people earn money here by hook or crook, illegal part-time jobs, body shops or multiple jobs, and then I don't know. Oh, but I'm not criticizing anyone here. I'm just sharing my experiences, and I've shown the boxes, right? 4 boxes. That is only my property in America. Mr. Tanul Thakur, who is writing book on my channel and about me biography or part of his story, whatever. And sorry for the interruption, brothers and sisters. He also asked me, Kumar, did you buy a house in Hyderabad after seeing or interviewing all this? But I want to show all my bank statements, both credit and debit, to only that gentleman, because he is writing book, and I am not sure whether I write a book or not. That is my autobiography or whatever my life story here. It will inspire many people who studied BA and who studied Masters in Computer, something like me, who has an aspiration to come to America. So that is my core intention. Point one. Point two, not to pay for money for jobs. Point three, not to pay money for visas. It's only especially. That is the core intention of writing or making videos from 2011. 2011 though I started the channel, but 2013 onwards I was active. In between 2018, I stopped because whatever the reasons it might be, and then I restarted after Tanul requested multiple times. So the life here is great, provided you have a green card. If you don't have, every Indian will rip you or rape you, man. Take my words for granted. And America is sleeping. America doesn't help. Even Americans also exploit. To quote an example, if any American marry Indian and it goes to divorce, it's a scam in both parties. So this is about my life in America. I don't know how people earn, because if employers, H-1B body shops pay salary as per USCIS laws, and Americans also follow, then you will mint a lot of money. In 2 years you become a millionaire and you can go back. But that is the dream I came here, but in reality it's not happens, because America is full of layers, illegal, illegal layers and multiple layers, and Indian hiring managers corrupt, and they have Layers company, Friends company, everywhere it is like that, across 50 states, 50 client locations. And you, from outside, people think that America is great, even laws and immigration laws are super strict. No, that is a false propaganda that America did or media did, whatever. So reality I've seen, right? That's my property, and I don't know how long I stay here. I gave up life 6 times. So that means I throw all my stuff and return to India 6 times with family. Again I returned. So you can imagine how much money I lost, and I was on credit. And then you know, right? I'm not hiding anything. And in spite of it, haters, They are saying Kumar is wrong. When I say don't pay money to H-1B or jobs, they're saying Kumar is wrong. That means my haters are mafia. My haters also started YouTube channels. I don't like to be a front face of anything. I never thought. YouTube also, I don't like it, but I'm making videos to educate my friends in India. But recently, Telugu people, Reddy's, Chowdhury's, various castes from Texas and other places started attacking me indirectly in videos. I don't care. These fuckers, they don't know. Sorry for using bad words. These guys doesn't know that I worked with 2 chief ministers with close association. Because of my honesty, the next VLSI company CEO also took me as an... He requested me to stay as a personal secretary to pay as much as I want. But I refused because I want to go to America like that. So that is my honesty, that's my level. And these workers, I don't really give care. I don't care, because of my honesty, the Times Magazine and my videos, they came and interviewed me and published me, Wired Magazine, and then other magazines, right? If I'm not honest, if I'm not genuine, and if I'm corrupt, why do they take my interviews, right? Especially advising, asking advice for Germany on H-1B to start or not. Then I gave whatever the best I can. I love India and Indians. I love human beings. I have a compassion, empathy and humanity. That is the reason, core reason I have started writing and explaining on all this. During my journey of life, one guy is very good friend of mine in Edison, New Jersey, and technical, but somebody trapped him into Amway, and then he also wants all my network training. Yeah, I bought this cup when I was 40. And when I started a Facebook group, Confrontational Book, they want all my followers, OPTs, EPTs, to give in to him for network training or placement, whatever. Later, I took him to a friend, some body shop, to start a body shop, how to start a body shop for, because he got a green card. It was 2015 or even before that. Then I met one of the CEO in when watching Telangana movie, Telugu movie, in Edison, New Jersey, and people come across in my life, I'm telling. And he was a CEO, he was professor in... He's a CEO, he was a professor in India, Guntur district of Andhra Pradesh, and then he started attacking me because I did BA or I did not get H-1B visa in 1999, and he got it. Whatever, he take a address, print out and put it on the wall. I visited his room several times, and then because he was alone, he kicked his wife and 2 daughters. They can't come back because he got a green card, they are major. These are all issues. For just to give a company, when I go, he used to attack me. And then I blocked him because unnecessary headache, right? So he has connected with some fake university people, whatever. So I left him. Later, during that time, 2011, when I'm confronting about casteism in Hinduism, one Hindu converted Christian person started attacking Hindus and Hinduism with me. Then he told he will help me writing a book. He introduced to some people and they're asking $5,000 to write a book. And then he created email ID, and he told give that email ID to everyone in the YouTube. I gave it, I trusted him, but there is only one way, he didn't trust me, and He didn't share emails, and he started collecting money, $10,000 from 12 sub, more than 12 subscribers. Unfortunately, become a layer or vendor employer in one of my projects. He also run away with my money, and later I left him. And this is how America life is. I'll continue as and when I get a points to tell. And life is great, America is great, but Indians are ripping each other. And when we, as you know, right, when F1 girl plays a video, everybody attacked. And one Revati, one F1 girl, spoke very daringly about body shops and all that stuff, and then many people attacked her body shops, and they also attacked me. And after that, best case, I put Sarath and Swaraj. But getting green card is tough. One guy got a O visa or EB1, whatever. But getting green card, life sucks here unless H1B picked up for F1 students, and H1Bs until get a green card. Green card ki people worry about US citizenship. They are, people live in a box here. That box may be phobia or green card or H1B or carrot, whatever you call. So, just a minute. It is really painful. But working with Americans is great. American work culture is great. And visiting different places. Life is great. But missing home country is very sad. And you know, right, 28 hours H1B has to work. And those many hours tax we have to pay. And oddly, can you imagine how many days we live outside in USA? If you stay more than 3 weeks, America doesn't allow you to come inside, because if you are not there in US, your job runs, means you don't need in USA, is the America concept. They don't say at port of entry, but if you stay 2 months, 6 months in outside and you are an H1B, then no use, right? So it's okay, you have dollars, you have others, that's what, it's apple to orange comparison, that's what people come unstuck, and then life is great. But I'm talking as if this is my last video before leaving US. And you have all credit cards, excess money, or if the employers pay full-time job, it's fine, but still their mind stuck with green card. I have a friend worked in VLSA in India. He was a very good friend of mine, and he drove from Canada to New York City to see, and then he gifted me one item at that time. He came to my house in New Jersey at midnight with family, and then he left, and then he told Kumo, he called one day and he told Kumar, I am watching your videos, and it's not for H1B or something. He is a top director cadre in VLSA company in Canada, and he moved to US. He told Kumar, at the top level meeting also some Indians will come and ask, do you have a green card and how did you get? This is what his experience he shared. That's why Indians, they count number of days and years while living here. That shows the depression, and they worry a lot. They worry for green card. Thank you. మళ్ళీ చెప్పండి, అమెరికా ఎందుకు వచ్చారు?
నీకు నాకు స్టఫ్ లేదు మాస్టర్, మనకి ఎవరు ఇండియా జాబ్ ఇవ్వట్లేదు. సో ఎచ్ఆర్ అప్లై చేసుకుని ఇక్కడ వచ్చాము. మనకి ఇండియాలో టీసీఎస్ కూడా పెద్ద కంపెనీ జాబ్ ఇచ్చుంటాం, ఇండియాలో ఉంటాము, అంతే కదా?
Yes, correct.
We don't have stuff, so we apply to America. That's it, as simple as that. It's not as if like, you know, we had big stuff. అమెరికాలో నువ్వు జాబ్ ఇస్తా అని చెప్పి మనకి ఎవరు ఇవ్వలేదు. ఎక్స్చేంజ్ చేసుకుని వచ్చాము. We never had stuff. That's reality. You have to accept it.